Hello, I'm Connie Wan. I'm curator of the Edwin Butler Bayliss Poet-Painter of the Black Country exhibition, and we're here in the gallery today so that I can tell you a little bit about the artist and his work. Now, Edwin Butler Bayliss was a Wolverhampton-born artist, born in 1874, just down the road in Turton Hall. And I'm actually standing here next to a portrait by Edwin himself of his father, Samuel Bayliss. Now, Samuel was co-managing director of the local iron foundry, Bayliss, Jones and Bayliss. Edwin was the eldest of eight children, and you would expect, as the eldest son especially, that he would have some involvement in the family firm. However, it seemed that he wasn't particularly interested and decided to pursue a career in art instead. But because of his family connections, he had access to a lot of local industrial sites, and hence he became known as the painter of the Black Country landscape. Now, the Black Country seems like an unlikely source of inspiration for any artist, but this painting here, Tipping the Slag, is something that we do typically associate with Butler Bayliss. He painted a lot of industrial Black Country scenes, lots of chimneys depicting the smog, using very sort of organic browns and ochres to depict the very dull atmosphere. However, he does use these very bright oranges just to perk up all the paintings and sort of draw the viewer's eyes into the painting itself. So this exhibition also aims to show the diversity of Butler Bayliss's work, and on display are a series of his conventional landscapes and also his coastal scenes. Now, him and his family actually went on holiday fairly often to the Welsh coast, and they went to areas such as Tenby and also Aberdovey. We can see Aberdovey in this work here. Now, stylistically, this is very different from Tipping the Slag that we saw a moment ago. That's possibly because this was a poster design for a GWR poster, showing that Butler Bayliss had other means of making an income. Although the Black Country landscape is very different today, it's still a source of inspiration for many contemporary artists. For example, Paul Hickgiss. He's a member of the Royal Birmingham Society of Artists, a society that Butler Bayliss was also a member of during his lifetime. Now, Paul is inspired by a lot of the Black Country canals, and he uses different print techniques and different paint media in order to create these scenes.